I hope so. That's the plan now. So I hope we find the budget and...
You know with who, actually?
Sorry?
You know with who, actually?
No, not yet. It's too early to say anything, because if I say something now, it will be different tomorrow anyway, so...
Conditions that are far from favorable, the race that could decide the championship.
You can see there already the spray.
Because this car has been, oh, and that's the problem. You see the Yamaha engine belching out smoke. It's let go. Let's hope it hasn't dropped any oil on the track. As Mick, fire marshals running down. Now, what's happened? That is the left and right, and it is Mika Salo, the unfortunate Mika Salo, coming out of the race in the Tyrrell Yamaha from sixth position. He had so hoped to do better.
Following through Salo in a Tyrrell, going out of our frame. And Salo bangs up to the back of Irvine. Is Häkkinen. Häkkinen then goes to the back of that. Does Häkkinen get out?
Irvine is даже мимо Дэймона Хилла. Да, мне кажется, да, в данной лиге сейчас на третьей позиции. Итак, Михаэль Шумахер выигрывает старт. Следом Жак Виньоп и Жанна Лизи, Дэймон Хилл лишь на четвертом месте. Далее Эдди Ирвайн и Гестер Бергер. Таким образом, первая шестерка выглядит так же, как и на старте, но внутри нее произойдет гораздо сложнее. Мы видим, что также уже сошел...
Both out. Yes, it is a Tyrrell. It's Salo. Just about managed to spot that there, and Salo obviously started.
I thought I can keep it up a few more laps, but then it just exploded on the straight.
May have got a puncture, a cut in his tyre. Could even be a vibration where he's blocked the left or right front wheels, and he's coming for a fresh set.
You see now a battle between the two Tyrrells. Jos Verstappen in the leading one. There he is with the yellow mini wings on the front of his car. And behind him is Mika Salo in ninth position. Behind him is Johnny Herbert. So V8 in second. He's taken on about 60 litres of fuel. It looks to me as though he's on a two-stop strategy. And look, the Tyrrell is trying to take, it's Verstappen. Is he going to get round? Yes, that was a demon move. My goodness, he runs very wide, but he's got past the Stewart. And now Salo is in ninth position. So Verstappen moves up to seventh place, only one place off the points. David Coulthard is now the fastest man on the track. He's in fourth position in the McLaren, 121.58. The lap record was broken a long time ago. It's now 0.4 of a second faster than the lap record previously. And how typical. Well, I don't know whether to tell you about this or tell you about Wilner. But I'll tell you about this. It's Mika Salo with the red mini wings on the front, trying to take seventh position still away from Rubens Barrichello, whilst Johnny Herbert behind him tries to take eighth position away from Salo. Seventh, eighth and ninth. And now Salo zooms up the inside of Barrichello. Great!
No, Salo's not there yet. He had to back off because there's a yellow flag because of the Schumacher incident. You cannot overtake under one way or another.
Yeah, I have to ask what may seem a silly question, Mark. Do you think that in any way Barrichello is playing a tactical race, forcing himself to go a bit slower than he could so that he can save pit stops?
Well, for sure it looks like they're going to do one stop at this pace. They can't be doing anything but that.
Yeah, and Barrichello dodges to the outside. Johnny Herbert's trying to follow through, and he's going to do it, is he? Let's see how the acceleration of the Ford V10 compares with Johnny Herbert's engine, the Ferrari-based engine, and it's about...
Wenn Sie auf unserem Cockpit-Kanal wählen. Jetzt ist der Start freigegeben, die Ampel springt auf grün und Mika Häkkinen kommt gut weg, aber Coulthard ist fast daneben. Häkkinen oder Coulthard, Schumacher auf 3, Häkkinen führt.
Und der rollt aus und dahinter auch gleich
Dinis.
Beide miteinander rollen aus. Beide kaputt.
Hier hat es einen zerrissen, einen Motor. Es
sind zwei Autos, die da stehen, ein Arrows und wer ist dahinter?
Das ist Mika Salo hier.
Salo steht.
You look at Mika Salo, still going strong. He has just lapped Jarno Trulli there in the front. Salo is in fifth position, going beautifully in the Arrows. His teammate Pedro Diniz is in seventh place, and we have seen Eddie
put those Arrows in the point.
Yeah, and that would be a fantastic achievement. Here is Mika Salo. Now, Salo drove for Tyrrell for 3 years after driving in a couple of races in Japan and Australia for Lotus. And he's always said he's got a lot more ability than he's been able to show. He's never had a car good enough to
do it. And takes the position from his teammate. And Fisichella is there now. And there is a very broken Arrows with Salo struggling to get out of it. And I do suspect that this hand, Johnny, is that Johnny Herbert? Yes, it's Johnny Herbert. So the race is going to be, the safety car is sure to come out again. This is a most incredible Canadian Grand Prix.
Very dangerous position. But there's an Arrows spinning off. But no harm done. He should, if he kept the engine going, he should recover from that. But no sign of any movement yet. And I think he's lost the engine. Yes, he's lost the engine.
Tyrrell, and coming up to turn two, it's Häkkinen.
Häkkinen leads. Lacy has made a bad start. There's Schumacher, I think.
Yes,
it was Russell. And another. There's another accident.
Yeah, and it's
Villeneuve Diniz. And that must be Coulthard.
And David Coulthard, yeah. And look at it, out of the race goes Mika Salo. I think he's got...
The
Arrows, and into the pits comes Mika Salo, followed by the Williams and the Benetton.
It looks like they're all circular, doesn't it? They're all coming in at the same time, but it's a straight fight, really, between the Williams mechanics and the Benetton mechanics. Benetton.
Former world champion Jody Scheckter alongside Murray Walker.
And you watch for the lights. They come on one at a time. When all five go out, there's a programmed pause at the San Marino Grand Prix.
Atrás. Estranhamente ele passou reto, ele perdeu o ponto da freada ali, travou as rodas aí e vira passageiro. Olha lá, olha lá, olha lá, olha lá, olha lá. Você tá vendo aí também o Mika Salo. O Mika Salo tinha até a sua primeira posição, estava na frente do Pedro.
Gestartet.
Guter Start von David Coulthard.
Einer steht, ein Arrows, jetzt kommt er weg.
Findet wohl keinen Platz, versucht es aus.
Das nein. Nicht.
Und Heinz-Harald Frenzen hat...
Yeah, no, Coulthard needs to make this stick somehow because he's now losing a second to lap Häkkinen. I was a bit surprised why Mika Häkkinen wasn't pulling away more up front. I suspect...
Yeah. Very, very tricky there.
Oh no, that's a bit of Coulthard's front wing gone missing. Coulthard's obviously just had a go at Salo and now loses the end fence off his front wing. He's going to lose some front grip with that. He may... Let me see if the secondary wing is in there. I can't see at the moment. If he's, yeah, look, he's lost it. He is going to lose.
Consumed with with rage, and the Tifosi are consumed with... As Coulthard sets a new fastest first section of the race, as the fuel is absolutely at minimum, they're nearly on fumes now, running with these cars, these two cars. Frentzen watching from third place, knowing that they've got to stop, they're going to be...
Look, he's third, well in sight of the race leaders, Salo and Coulthard, both of whom have got to stop. And you know from Martin's superb piece before this programme began, on pit stop strategies and everything that happens, how much it's going to slow them down.
Coulthard peeling off, in fact, is Salo too. Coulthard all locked up, trying to get down to the speed limit, and I think taking a faster run into his clearer pit gear, James.
Yeah, Salo in and DC as well, as the fuel's going in. Martin, as DC gets out behind Salo, but don't forget with Frentzen, he was only stationary for 7.6 seconds. Now at this stage of the race, that means he's not put as much fuel in. It was a tactical move by Jordan. They brought him in earlier. His fuel tank would have allowed him to go longer, but they brought him in earlier because they knew that everybody else was going to do it too. So he actually has played a very good card, I think.
Yes, and Barrichello has, he stopped very early of these leaders, Barrichello, but that's put him up
3 seconds behind, notwithstanding the fact he has a much less powerful engine. But Heinz Harald Frentzen wins at Monza in Italy. 10 world championship points, another magnificent victory for Jordan. There is the ecstatic cut in the Jordan pit area. So Salo is third for Ferrari. Barrichello and Coulthard are coming through. That's how close they are.
Thank you. schon so spannend wie hier vorhin vorne an der Spitze. Weber 33,2, der kann jetzt zulegen. Salo 33,5. Und hier wird es immer enger. 0,9. So, jetzt gibt es doch noch mal ein Duell. Jetzt kommt die beste Stelle. Die lange Startzielgerade. Und da kann sich Weber vorne halten. Das war hier die beste Möglichkeit.
Jetzt kommt die Haarnadel. Das ist der Schumacher. Oh, er macht den Fehler!
Salo macht ihn und nicht Weber. Und ich sag doch 94 Grand Prix.
Ja, und auch vorwärts einparken bedeutet normalerweise.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Das war's.
Somit, Tog greift nach Salo und.
Schafft's.
Kriegt ihn.
Der Kerl ist frech, hä? Richtig gut hat er das gemacht. Bravo. Die Marokko kann man nicht überholen, habe ich gehört.
Salo, ja. Der kommt wohl rein, aber Massa und Button sind da vorbeigeschossen.
Hätte die Beine außenrum überholen können wieder.
Hier die erste Box ist die von Toyota. Da werden auch nur Hinterreifen gewechselt. Interessant.
Ja, das kennen wir seit Monaco. Dass man an den Hinterreifen bei solchen Strecken mit Stop and Go.
An identical situation to fellow Finn Raikkonen. Locked that brake up early and really could do nothing about it. You've missed the moment to get the major part of your speed off and get the whole thing down. And a rally crossing there then as Mika Salo rejoins, still in 18th place.
Man on the move at the moment, certainly in the midfield runners, is Jacques Villeneuve, up now right behind his team mate Olivier Panis, and Jacques Villeneuve going so strongly.
Sempre acontece. Eles passam completando a sexta volta e vibrando o torcedor quando passaram Montoya e Schumacher. Olha o Barrichello. Agora o Barrichello deixa para trás e Mika Salo. Barrichello já assume a oitava posição, como você vê aí no vídeo. Barrichello.
En sa faveur, ce qui l'idée d'avis de voir les gens dans la Bridgestone. Tout à fait. Les Toyota sont en Michelin et la barre de Villeneuve en Bridgestone.
Vous avez vu ça? Plus difficile, attention.
Toyota en feu, c'est celle de Mika Salo. Alors, 22 tours encore, il faut tenir, monsieur Raikkonen.
Die Stärke, die Geschwindigkeiten sagen allerdings kaum einen Unterschied.
Salo de la Rosa. Ja, also das liefert uns schon im Ansatz so etwas wie Spannung. Das japanische Duell Toyota Honda, dann BRR gegen John, Salo gegen niemand. Also da ist einiges drin.
Und hier haben wir einen Positionswechsel. Da ist